Secure your super male vitality. InfoWarsLife.com.
A chemical spill contaminating the water supply in 9 West Virginia counties.
This year alone, over 300,000 people in West Virginia had their drinking water contaminated.
What are the health effects of having these drugs in our drinking water?
It's forced medical treatment without the consent of residents.
My friends, water filtration is one of the most basic actions you can take to protect you and your family from the harmful toxins and heavy metals in your tap water.
On average, the county says it sprays with glyphosate at least once a week.
Few filters cut out the glyphosate that is found in water supply worldwide. Remove pesticides, herbicides, chloramines, hydrofluorosilicic acid, sodium hexafluorosilicate.
Fluoride, it is in tea, it's in coffee, it's in water, it's in bread, it's in toothpaste.
It is our responsibility to protect our families. The establishment's not going to do it. It's time to take action. It's time to filter our water. Visit InfoWarsStore.com and use promo code WATER to get 10% off their entire family of incredible products. Or call toll free 888-253-3139. This is Alex Jones for InfoWarsLife.com. The latest in preparedness is now here. An electrically stabilized colloidal silver solution that can be added to both your home cabinet and preparedness pack alike. Concentrated to 30 parts per million. And what has been dubbed the survival silver solution, the new InfoWars Life Silver Bullet Colloidal Silver is the answer for you and your family. And it's entirely free of toxic artificial additives that are loaded into many products. The InfoWars Life Silver Bullet Silver is so powerful that it is concentrated into a 2-ounce bottle and is not recommended for extended continual use. This is not a low-grade formula. We are working with one of the top laboratory manufacturers in the United States to bring you the best form of colloidal silver using electrical processes within a base of deionized water for your preparedness storage or your home kitchen. Purchase your bottle of InfoWarsLife.com Silver Bullet Colloidal Silver today and find other amazing supplements at InfoWarsLife.com. Alex Jones here to tell you about how you can help spread liberty worldwide while also enjoying what I have found to be the best-tasting 100% organic coffee on the planet. For more than a decade, my favorite coffee has come from the high mountains of southern Mexico, where the Chiapas farmers grow their unique shade-grown Arabica beans. We have now managed to secure these sought-after beans in a highly customized blend. Discover and try a bag of the Patriot Blend 100% organic coffee at InfoWarsLife.com. This coffee gives you a long, smooth pick-me-up for hours without the headaches and heartburn that so many other coffees give me personally. Hands down, this is my favorite coffee, and it's taken us years to secure connections directly to the Chiapas Mexican farmers. Drop by the site today, order a bag or two, and I don't think you're going to be disappointed. Available in original or with our immune support infusion blend, you will be supporting a free press, all the while enjoying a truly great-tasting cup of my favorite coffee. Available at InfoWarsLife.com.
Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
Generals gathered in their masses, just like witches.
He aligns himself with the truth. And it's time for you to choose a side. You're listening to Alex Jones.
Sorcerer of death's construction. In the fields of bodies burning.
Well, we have George Galloway on with us for the next 40 minutes or so, 45 minutes or so. He is a British politician, writer, broadcaster, and Respect Party member of Parliament from Bradford West. And he is very well known for testifying before the U.S. Congress. He is very well known for exposing the Iraq war as a lie and a fraud before it happened. Then they, of course, murdered Dr. David Kelly to try to cover that up. He helped expose that. He's been pushing for Tony Blair and others to be held for war crimes, which they clearly have done by every yardstick. We've had members of the U.S. Senate look at it and say clearly it's a war crime. They fixed the intelligence. The White House memo, the Downing Street memos have all come out. We know. Prima facie, cookie, you know, jar, hand in the cookie jar, red-handed, we have them. George, thank you for coming on the show.
It's a pleasure, Alex. Nice to talk to you again.
Where would you like to start? There's so much to talk about.
Well, I think the most immediate crisis is the one now in the Ukraine, the Crimea, with Russia, and the Cold War beginning to encroach upon our toes. My toes are feeling distinctly frosty with all the rhetoric, which takes us back to the 1970s, 1980s. And having had a period of honeymoon, Russia appears to be back as public enemy number one. And the hypocrisy that's being deployed would be laughable if it were not so serious. In Britain, for example, we have a government which in 1982 sailed 7,000 miles all the way to the South Atlantic to defend the rights of self-determination of 2,300 British settlers on what they call the Falkland Islands. They fought a devastating war in which many hundreds were killed, many more were maimed, and billions of pounds in treasure were burned in order to come to the aid of what we said were our compatriots, even though we planted them there in the first place. Equally, our government, if Spain were to have the temerity to just severely increase the traffic restrictions on traffic going from Spain to Gibraltar and vice versa, we'd be ready to go to war with Spain, because we say that the rock which is attached to Spain actually belongs to us. And yet the same government warns Russia of condign punishments to come because they intervened to safeguard their vital national interests, and millions of their compatriots, Russian nationals, Russian speakers, whose lives and property were very obviously at risk from a Western-sponsored and paid for and logistically armed in every way coup d'etat in the neighboring country of Ukraine. I could go on, but I just will give one more example of the hypocrisy, or perhaps two. The Kosovo, which is a part of Serbia, declared itself unilaterally to be an independent state, and 110 countries in the world have recognized it, recognized this self-declared independence. And guess what? Both my country and yours are amongst the 110 countries that have recognized.
And look at South Sudan. Exactly. Look at South Sudan.
Just one more. Permit me, yes, South Sudan, but permit me one more irony. John Kerry, with a solemn face, said that we can't have countries invading others and seizing territory on trumped-up pretext. And he didn't even have the grace to laugh. When just 11 years ago, exactly yesterday, Britain and the United States, in their shock and awe invasion and attack on Iraq, began a process which has murdered a million souls, destroyed Iraq, shattered it into pieces, and sent cascading around the world Islamist fundamentalist fanatic extremism all over the globe, all in the name of Britain and America arrogating to themselves the right to do whatever they please, irrespective of the decision of the United Nations or of anything called international law. You couldn't make it up, Alex.
Incredible the way George Galloway puts it. Total veritas. I agree with you 100%. And Ron Paul on the libertarian right came out and wrote articles and said exactly what you just said, almost word for word, because it is just the truth. Neither one of you is plagiarizing the other. It's just the truth. And they are calling him basically a KGB agent. Sir, continuing, is there a method to the madness in Syria, in Libya? Because, I mean, this looks like something the devil would do. Yes. Just to try to wreck any stability. What's the game plan?
Well, I wish I knew. I shared a lift with William Hague, the British foreign minister, just a week or two ago. And I said to him, William, you've been wrong all of your life, but I've never known you to be actually insane. Yet the policy you're following in Syria is literally insane. You have inflated, financed, and armed Al-Qaeda in Syria on the principle that your enemy's enemy was your friend. Yet now you tell us that returning fanatics coming back from Syria, now that they're losing the war, are Britain's number one security concern. So you've made more dangerous the very people that you say are our number one national security threat. This has to be defined as insanity, doesn't it?
It is, and I've been following politics for decades, but never have seen something this surreal. Where is it going as the open mental illness, the fascist mental illness, just explodes and metastasizes?
Well, I'm now making a movie called The Killing of Tony Blair. It's not a snuff movie. It doesn't involve me killing Tony Blair, though that would probably be quite a popular movie. It's about the killings of Tony Blair, the killings carried out by Tony Blair, and the financial killing that he is making as a result of the other killings that he had been doing. And so I hope that we'll get him sacked as the Middle East peace envoy, the most grotesque appointment since Caligula appointed his horse as a proconsul of Rome. I hope that it will stop companies from hiring him. He's made more than £75 million, so $100 million, since leaving office, working for the tyrants and the companies that he so handsomely profited and benefited when he was in office. And I'm about to start making a movie to try and punish the American political class. It's called Where's Kenny Boy? It fastens on the criminal Kenneth Lay, who may or may not have died of a heart attack just before being sentenced for his crimes in the collapse of Enron, and may or may not be living on a 100,000-acre ranch owned by George Bush in Paraguay, cheek by jowl with the biggest American base in the region, just so people who want to look over the fence might be discouraged from doing so.
Oh, absolutely.
And we're now crowdfunding for that movie.
George Galloway, we got to go to break.
It's called Where's Kenny Boy? And your viewers and listeners, I hope, will go to start, join, and support it.
Okay, George, stay there. We're going to come back from break, and we'll talk about the film, because I followed this, and I'm glad you're making it. And I hope folks will support it, because clearly he staged his death 2 days before sentencing and has been seen down there at the Bush Ranch. I mean, they sheep-dipped him, folks. They stage deaths all the time. George Galloway's our guest. Stay with us.
From the water table to our soils to the atmosphere itself, our world is becoming more and more toxic each and every day. But it's not just the air outside that's toxic. Indoor air has been shown to have 2 to 5 times higher concentrations of pollutants than even outdoor air. And most Americans spend 90% of their time inside using toxic chemicals within their homes. There are more than 42 million smokers in the United States. Well over 1,000 types of mold and mildew linked to numerous conditions. And don't forget the fact that 6 million Americans live with pets they're allergic to as well. When I began to research these statistics, it was clear to me it was time to start cleansing my lungs in order to combat the toxic environment that we cannot escape, but that we can fight back against. Made with organic and wild cultivated herbs and manufactured in the USA, the new InfoWars Life Lung Cleanse is here in a convenient spray bottle that can be brought with you throughout any toxic environment. Now available exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3133. The globalists have controlled the mainstream media for a long time, but now they're expanding, making the weaponization even more vicious and deceptive. All the major networks are state-run.
We are partnering this year with the NFL.
The NFL has become a political weapon against the Second Amendment and pushes Obamacare. MSNBC tells us that our children belong to the state.
We have to break through our kind of private idea that kids belong to their parents or kids belong to their families and recognize that kids belong to whole communities.
It is more important than ever to realize realize that we are not the alternative media. We are the true media. The establishment dinosaur press is dying.
We are in an information war, and we are losing that war.
Join us at InfoWarsNews.com and PrisonPlanet.tv. Members can share their memberships with up to 11 people. By subscribing, you will literally be buying war bonds in the InfoWar to expand our operation in the face of the tyrants.